Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. So today is the class 4 of biomolecules revision. In this class, we are going to discuss the MCQs regarding CET, NEET and JEE. Yes, in your volume 4, page number 131, the chapter is biomolecules. Volume 4, page number 131. Yes, question number 16. The question number is 16. Find the hydrolysis product of maltose. Yes, maltose. What is the formula of maltose? The formula of maltose is C12H22O11. Maltose, that is an example of disaccharide. So first we are going to understand what is a disaccharide. Disaccharide means that is a carbohydrate which upon hydrolysis in presence of dilute acids or in presence of enzymes, the disaccharide is going to give two molecules of either the same type of monosaccharides or different type of monosaccharides. Yes, to understand this one, suppose if you are going to take a sucrose, C12H22O11, when it is going hydrolysis, then it is going to give two compounds. One is C6H12O6, that is D plus glucose. The second one, C6H12O6, that is D minus fructose. So a carbohydrate upon hydrolysis, if it is going to give two monosaccharides of same type or different type, then that carbohydrate is called as a disaccharide. From this reaction, we can say that sucrose is an example of a disaccharide. Sucrose and hydrolysis gives D plus glucose and D minus fructose. But in our question number 16, the question given is, find the hydrolysis products of maltose. Yes, coming to the maltose. This is from your NCERT textbook. Yes, see this one, maltose. When maltose is undergoing hydrolysis, the maltose is going to give two simple monosaccharides. This is the complete structure of maltose. The maltose is containing two simple monosaccharides linked with each other through glycosidic linkage. This linkage, single bond oxygen, single bond between two monosaccharide units is called as a glycosidic linkage. And this is the structure of maltose. Maltose is containing alpha D glucose and alpha D glucose. So first alpha D glucose, first carbon, is going to be bonded with or going to be bridged with fourth carbon of second alpha D glucose. See this one, this is the fourth carbon of second alpha D glucose. So here in maltose, the glycosidic linkage is present between C1 carbon atom of alpha D glucose to C4 carbon atom of another alpha D glucose. So in this case, when the maltose is going under hydrolysis, the maltose can give two simple monosaccharides, that is glucose units only. Which type of glucose units? Alpha D glucose units. So we can say that maltose is an example of a disaccharide. So maltose is composed of two alpha D glucose units in which C1 of one glucose linked to C4 of another glucose. This is the C1 carbon of one glucose linked to C4 carbon of another glucose, and this linkage is called as glycosidic linkage. So for the given question here, question number 16, find the hydrolysis product of maltose. So we can say that alpha D glucose and alpha D glucose. Option is first option, alpha D glucose plus alpha D glucose. Right? And question number 18. Yes, question number 18 is, which one of the following statement is not true regarding plus lactose? Once again, which one of the following statement is not true regarding plus lactose? Question number 18. Yes, in your textbook, NCERT textbook, you can see about lactose here. Lactose, the formula is also same. C12H22O11. This is also an example of a disaccharide. And lactose is mainly found in milk. So lactose is called as milk sugar. The lactose is called as milk sugar. And the lactose is composed of beta D galactose and beta D glucose. Once again, the lactose is composed of beta D galactose and beta D glucose. See the structure here. So this is the unit beta D glucose, beta D galactose unit, and this is the unit beta D glucose unit. C1 carbon of beta D galactose is going to be linked with C4 carbon of beta D glucose. So here we can say that the glycosidic linkage, what is the glycosidic linkage in lactose? The C1 carbon of beta D galactose is going to be linked with C4 carbon of beta D glucose. So there is about lactose. And here the question number 18, what is the question number 18? Page number is 131. Volume 4, page number 131, question number 18. Which one of the following statement is not true regarding plus lactose? Yes, option number 4. Plus lactose is a reducing sugar and does not exhibit mutar rotation. Yes, plus lactose. This is a reducing sugar, no doubt. No doubt it is a reducing sugar. How can we say it is a reducing sugar? Because when lactose is undergoing hydrolysis, it is going to give beta D galactose and beta D glucose. The beta D glucose can exhibit anomeric form with its alpha D glucose. So one of the unit of lactose can give anomeric forms. So in the lactose, what is going to give the anomeric forms? Beta D glucose is going to give the anomeric forms. Hence, mutar rotation is possible. In the lactose, mutar rotation is possible. And one more thing, this lactose here, this lactose is having hemiacetal group. What is meant by hemiacetal group? See this carbon, C1 carbon, the same carbon atom having single bond oxygen single bond group. Single bond oxygen single bond group. This group is called as ether group. And the same carbon is having OH group. So whenever the same carbon having both ether group and alcohol group, that is called as hemiacetal. Hemiacetal. So this beta D glucose upon hydrolysis, it is going to give a hemiacetal form that can be converted into aldehyde group that can be reduced. So then we can say that lactose is an example of reducing sugar, and lactose is found in milk. Hence, lactose is an example of milk sugar, and lactose can give or lactose can undergo mutar rotation. Right? But if you say the question number 18, option number 4, plus lactose is a reducing sugar. Yes, that is correct. And does not exhibit mutar rotation. This is not correct. Lactose can exhibit mutar rotation because of beta D glucose unit, which is going to have C1 carbon atom with ether group and alcohol group, that is a hemiacetal group is present. Hence, beta D glucose can exhibit mutar rotation. So for the question number 18, option number 4 is the answer. So what the concept here present? What is the concept present here? Lactose is a reducing sugar as well as it can undergo mutar rotation. Yes, very, very important topic it is. Disaccharides. Yes, okay. Next, question number 19. Read the question number 19. Which one of the following sets of monosaccharides form sucrose? Which one of the following sets of monosaccharides forms sucrose? Formation of sucrose. In the last video also we discussed the formation of sucrose. Sucrose, the formula C12H22O11. Sucrose is formed from glucose and fructose. See here, which type of glucose is taken? Alpha D glucose is going to be glycosidic linkage with beta D fructose. So simply we can say that sucrose can be obtained by the reaction of alpha D glucose with beta D fructose, with the elimination of one water molecule. To understand this statement, please see the previous video. There I written the equation for the formation of sucrose from glucose and fructose. Right? So for the question number 19, page number is 131. Volume 4, chapter is biomolecules, page number 131. Question number 19. Which one of the following sets of monosaccharides form sucrose? What we have to answer? Alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. If you say the option number 4, question number 19, option number 4, alpha D glucopyranose is given. Alpha D glucopyranose is given. Yes, all of us know glucose, the cyclic form is similar to pyran. This is the structure similar to pyran structure. Please see the textbook to understand properly. This is the structure similar to pyran structure. Hence, alpha D glucose is also called as alpha D glucopyranose. And this is the structure similar to furan. This is the structure similar to furan. Hence, beta D fructose is called as beta D fructofuranose. Alpha D glucopyranose, beta D fructofuranose. So, for the question number 19, option is 4. Very, very, very important topic these are. Please try to understand. If you are having the doubts, you can call me, we'll discuss. Next, say the question number 20. Say the question number 20. Page number 131, volume 4, biomolecules, question number 1, question number 20. D plus glucose reacts with hydroxyl amine, yields an oxime. The structure of oxime would be D plus glucose. Yes, we are going to see the open chain structure of glucose. We are going to see the open chain structure of glucose, D plus glucose. Here we are seeing that anomeric forms, left side and the right side, these two are interconvertible readily with each other. They are said to be as anomeric forms, alpha D plus glucose and beta D plus glucose. And these are the cyclic forms. I'm not going to take the cyclic form. I'm going to take the open chain structure of glucose, D plus glucose. This is the open chain structure of D plus glucose. If you say the second carbon is having OH group on the right side, third carbon having OH group on the left side, fourth and fifth carbons are having OH groups on the right side, and sixth one is having CH2OH. So second carbon is having OH group on the right side. So on the board, we are going to write the structure of D plus glucose. How can we write the structure of D plus glucose? D plus glucose. First of all, glucose, the formula, C6H12O6. Yes, glucose formula, C6H12O6. And we are taking D plus glucose. About this relative configuration, capital D. In the last class also we discussed the same. Please watch the previous video to understand what is capital D. The structure given is C double bond O, single bond H, single bond C. This is the functional group, aldehyde group. Now it is the second carbon. Second carbon having OH group on the right side, hydrogen on the left side. At the third carbon, OH group is present on the left side, hydrogen is present on the right side. 1, 2, 3. At the fourth carbon as well as at the fifth carbon, OH groups are present on the right side, hydrogen atoms are present on the left side. And at the sixth carbon, CH2OH group is present. Yes, in the last video I said that if this type of configuration is there, this is indicating capital D configuration. This is similar to D-glyceraldehyde. So this glucose is said to be D-glucose. And why we are saying plus means, when we are going to use plain polarized light. The plain polarized light is going to be rotated. The plain polarized light is going to be rotated in the clockwise direction. Like this. Hence, this is optically active compound. And this is called as a dextro compound. when the plane polarized light is going to be rotated by a compound in the clockwise direction, such compounds are called as dextro compounds. Dextro compounds are represented with plus symbol. Otherwise, dextro compounds are represented with small d hyphen. So instead of writing plus symbol, here we can also write small d hyphen. That means we can call the glucose as d hyphen small d hyphen glucose. Otherwise, we can say it is as d plus glucose. Anyhow, our question given is question number 20. Yes, read the question number 20. D plus glucose reacts with hydroxyl amine, yields an oxime. The structure of oxime would be, yes, aldehyde group. This is aldehyde group. When an aldehyde is going to react with hydroxyl amine, what is the hydroxyl amine? What is the hydroxyl amine? NH2 single bond OH. Otherwise, simply I can write NH2 single bond OH. So in simple, we can write the formula as NH2OH. NH2OH is called as hydroxyl amine. So whenever aldehyde is going to react with hydroxyl amine. Yes, aldehyde. How can we represent the aldehyde group? Single bond, C double bond O, single bond H. This is aldehyde group. This is the aldehyde group. When the aldehyde group is going to react with the hydroxyl amine. Hydroxyl amine, for your understanding purpose, I am writing the hydroxyl amine as NH2OH. NH2OH, hydroxyl amine. Now, in this reaction, water molecule is going to be removed. Whenever a reaction is going to happen, when two simple molecules are going to react with each other to form a large molecule, by the elimination of small molecules, we said that the reaction is an example of condensation reaction. Condensation reaction. In the polymers chapter, we discussed about condensation reactions. So whenever simple molecules are going to react with each other to form a large molecule by the elimination of small molecules, then such reaction is called as condensation reaction. Here, elimination of or removal of water molecule is going to take place. When the removal of water molecule is going to take place, a large molecule is going to be formed. What is the large molecule going to be formed? The large molecule going to be formed is when these are going to be reacted with each other on heating, water molecule is going to be removed. What is going to be formed? C single bond, here hydrogen is there. Between carbon and nitrogen, a double bond is going to be formed. And nitrogen is bonded with single bond OH. Yes, if you observe the group here, what is the group formed? Carbon, double bond, nitrogen, single bond OH. Here, this is the group, double bond N, single bond OH group. This group is called as oxime. So what is the functional group of oxime? What is the group of oxime? Oxime contains double bond N, single bond OH group. So this is an example of ald oxime. This is an example of ald oxime. This is the example of ald oxime. How can we say it is ald oxime? Because when an aldehyde is going to react with hydroxylamine, the obtained oxime is called as aldoxime. So you have to remember the structure of aldoximes. Single bond C, single bond H, double bond N, single bond OH. That is the structure of aldoximes. Now coming to our question, when the D plus glucose is going to react with hydroxylamine, what will be the structure going to be obtained? When the D plus glucose, when it is going to react with hydroxyl amine, when the D plus glucose is going to react with hydroxyl amine, what will be the structure going to be obtained? So to understand this one, first we have to remember the structure of D plus glucose. What is the structure of D plus glucose? First of all, aldehyde group. Next, second carbon, right side OH group.
left side hydrogen. Third carbon, left side OH group, right side hydrogen. Fourth carbon and fifth carbon. At the fourth carbon and fifth carbon, OH groups are present on right side, hydrogens are present on left side. And at the sixth position, CH2OH. So this is the structure of D plus glucose. Now, it is going to react with a hydroxyl amine. For our convenient purpose, I'm going to rearrange. Just, I'm going to write like this. C, double bond O, single bond H. Yes, this is also the same. D plus glucose. When this is going to react with hydroxyl amine, yes, tell me the formula of hydroxyl amine. NH2, right, NH2, single bond OH. Now remole off. Remole off. Water molecule is going to take place on heating. Remole off. Water molecule is going to take place. Yes. Now you can guess the structure of oxime going to be obtained. What is the structure of oxime going to be obtained? C single bond H. C single bond H. Between carbon and nitrogen, a double bond is going to be formed. Single bond OH. Next remaining is same as it is. There is no change. Second carbon having OH group on the right side, hydrogen on left side. Third carbon having OH group on left side, hydrogen on right side. Fourth carbon and fifth carbon are having OH groups on right side, hydrogen atoms on left side. And the sixth position is going to have CH2OH. So this is the answer, final answer. So this is the oxygen going to be obtained. So if you check your options, if you check your options, this is the answer for your given question. When the D plus glucose is going to react with hydroxylamine, what will be the oxime going to be obtained? This is the structure of oxime going to be obtained. Now, for the simplicity, take this one as CHOH. 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 Once again, CHOH, 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 CHOH. How many times? Four times it is. CHOH groups, how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4 times is there. So to simplify this one, I can write this one as C single bond H, double bond N, single bond OH, single bond CH OH taken 4 times. One time, second time, third time, fourth time. 4 times and single bond CH2OH. So this is going to be our answer. Yes, once check that options given. Once check the options given. What are the options given there? Yes. For your convenient purpose, I am moving a little bit side. So see the option number 1. Option number 2. Option number 3. And option number 4. Yes, go for option number 4. Go for the option number 4. Go for the option number 4. But in the option number 4 in our material, on the right side at the second carbon, on the right side OH group is given. On the left side also OH group is given. It is not correct. So here what should be there? What should be there? Hydrogen should be there. So the option is 4. But you have to change at the second carbon on the left side. It is not the OH group. It is only the hydrogen. Right? So this is a complete oxime going to be obtained when D plus glucose is going to react with hydroxylamine. And D plus glucose is containing C double bond O single bond H group. C double bond O single bond H group, that is aldehyde. So this is an example of aldose. D plus glucose. D plus glucose is an example of aldose. And D plus glucose is containing carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons. 6 carbons containing carbohydrate. The 6 carbons containing carbohydrate is called as hexose. So finally we can say that D plus glucose is an example of aldohexose. And it is containing which group? D plus glucose is containing which group? D plus glucose is containing aldehyde group. Aldehyde group can reduce tollens reagent. Aldehyde group can reduce tolensriazin. So we can say that D plus glucose is an example of which type of sugar? D plus glucose is an example of reducing sugar, because the D plus glucose is containing the aldehyde group that can reduce the tolensriazin. Hence, we can say that D plus glucose is an example of a reducing sugar. D plus glucose is containing 6 carbons, hence it is a hexose. And D plus glucose is containing aldehyde group, hence we can say that it is as aldose. Aldose plus hexose is called as aldohexose. So from this concept, we can understand so many things. And we know that glucose, if you taste the glucose, we can feel taste like sweet. So which type of carbohydrate it is? That is sugar like means sweet. So here carbohydrates are classified into two types based on the tastes. The carbohydrates are classified into two types. One is the sugars, second one is the non sugars. The carbohydrates which are not having taste like sweet, they are called as non sugars. The carbohydrates which are having taste like sweet, they are called as sugars. So whether glucose is an example of sugar or not, yes, it is an example of sugar. It is a simple sugar. But regularly we are saying sugar, we are using sugar, that is the sucrose. So regular table sugar in our home, on the table we are having the sugar, that is the table sugar. The table sugar, the formula is C12H22O11, that is a sucrose. So sucrose is also an example of sugar. Glucose is also an example of sugar, but glucose is an example of simple sugar, whereas sucrose is an example of complex sugar. Once again, sucrose is an example of complex sugar, whereas glucose is an example of a simple sugar. So that is all about D plus glucose. So question number 20, the option number 4, but that was not correct in your material. You have to change at the second carbon. What you have to take? Only hydrogen, but not OH group. So option number 4 is correct, but you have to change the second carbon containing hydrogen only on the left side, but not the OH group. Very, very, very important topic it is. Yes. Next, we are going to see the next question. Question number 24. Yes, you can tell me. What is the answer for question number 24? Yes, the page number is 132, volume 4, biomolecules chapter, page number 132. Okay, question number 24. Yes, read the question number 24 and see the options. Read the options and tell me the answer. Read it fast. My dear students, biomolecules chapter, except of carbohydrates, remaining topics, just by reading the theory and by remembering them, you can understand the MCQs. You can understand the MCQs just by reading and understanding them. You can practice the MCQs easily. But in the carbohydrates, little bit of depth is there. So please have some more focus in carbohydrates. Yes, question number 24, page number 132. Yes, what is the question given here? Which one of the following is a non-reducing sugar? Which one of the following? Which one of the following is a non-reducing sugar? Which one of the following is a non-reducing sugar? Just now I said that classification of sugars. Here sugars means, what is meant by sugars in general? In general, sugars means carbohydrates. So here the sugars are classified into two types, or the carbohydrates are classified into two types. One is the reducing sugars. Second one is the non-reducing sugars. reducing sugars and non-reducing sugars. Yes, in the last video, I explained the same thing. Reducing sugars means they can reduce tolerance reagent. They can reduce tolerance reagent and Phelan's solution. Phelan's solution. So when tolerance reagent or Phelan's solution is going to react with a sugar, if the tolerance reagent or the Phelan's solution is going to be reduced, then such type of sugars are called as reducing sugars. So when the tolerance reagent or the Phelan's solution is not going to be reduced with a sugar, that is called as non-reducing sugar. So to undergo reduction, what is required? What is required? Aldehyde group is required. And of course, ketone group is also be there. If the ketone group is there, alpha carbon is going to contain hydrogen atoms. This is the alpha carbon. If the alpha carbon of keto group is going to contain hydrogen atoms, such keto groups can also be reduced. Such keto groups can also reduce the tolerance reagent or Phelan's solution. So in simple, we can say that all the monosaccharides are the examples of reducing sugars. Yes, we are going to see the examples. What are the examples of reducing sugars? Very, very, very important topic for the CET and NEET as well as for JEE. So on the screen, we are seeing the classification now. Classification of sugars. Yes, here you can see the paragraph underlined with blue ink. The paragraph underlined with blue ink from your NCERT class 12 chemistry textbook. The carbohydrates may also be classified as either reducing or non-reducing sugars. All those carbohydrates which reduce Phelan's solution and tolerance reagent are referred to as reducing sugars. So the carbohydrates which can reduce both Phelan's solution and tolerance reagent are called as reducing sugars. And all the monosaccharides are the examples of reducing sugars, whether they may contain aldose or they may contain keto group. So irrespective of the aldehyde group or the keto group, all the monosaccharides are the reducing sugars. Yes, I think so. Here some table is given. Yes, just a minute, I will show you the table. Is it given or not? Okay, yes, here you can see now the different types of monosaccharides. If the monosaccharide is containing 3 carbons only, that is called as a triose. If the monosaccharide containing 4 carbons, tetrose. If the monosaccharide containing 5 carbons, pentose. If the monosaccharide containing 6 carbons, hexose. 7 carbons, heptose. And a triose containing aldehyde group is called as aldotriose. Triose containing keto group is called as ketotriose. Like that, aldotetrose, ketotetrose, aldopentose, ketopentose, aldohexose, ketohexose, aldoheptose and ketoheptose. But in our syllabus, we are given with glucose and fructose. Glucose contains aldehyde functional group, hence glucose is aldose and it is called as aldohexose because it contains 6 carbons. Whereas the fructose contains keto functional group, hence it is called as ketose and it contains 6 carbons, hence it is called as ketohexose. So first you have to remember, glucose is an example of aldohexose, fructose is an example of ketohexose. Even though they are containing aldehyde and ketone different functional groups, glucose and fructose can reduce the tolerance reagent and Phelan's solution. Yes, glucose we can say directly because it is containing aldehyde group. Aldehyde group can reduce the tolerance reagent and Phelan's solution directly. But in the case of fructose, even though it is containing the keto functional group, yes, see here about fructose. Yes, on the screen you can see now structure of fructose. Yes, this is the open chain structure of fructose. In the last video also I explained the same. Second carbon is having C double bond O group. That is keto functional group is present. Keto functional group is there. And first carbon is having alcohol group. And first carbon is the alpha carbon. Alpha carbon containing hydrogen. Hence, this ketone can undergo keto-enol tautomerism, and then it can form an aldehyde in the presence of a base. Hence, the fructose can also give an aldehyde group due to keto-enol tautomerism, that is enolization of keto group and the formation of aldehyde group in the presence of a base. So regarding this statement, please watch the previous video. In the last video, I discussed the same thing once again, right? So finally, we can conclude that all the monosaccharides are the reducing sugars. What about the disaccharides? Yes, it is the main key point you have to understand. So when coming to the disaccharides, in our textbook, we are given with three disaccharides. The first disaccharide given is sucrose. When sucrose structure is observed, sucrose is going to contain two monosaccharides, alpha D glucose and beta D fructose. C1 carbon of alpha D glucose is glycosidic linkage with C2 carbon of beta D fructose. Alpha D glucose can give anomeric forms. Beta D fructose can also give anomeric forms. Even though the anomeric forms are possible. Yes, just a minute, Ma. Something has happened here. Okay. Even though the anomeric forms are possible by alpha D glucose and beta D fructose, but here there is no presence of free aldehyde group. There is no presence of free ketone group because C1 carbon. See this one, C1 carbon. So C1 carbon, that is a functional group containing carbon. There is no free aldehyde group. Here it is the C2 carbon. There is no ketone. Free ketone is present. So whenever in a saccharide or in a carbohydrate, if there is no presence of free aldehyde group or free ketone group, such carbohydrates cannot reduce Tollens reagent and Fehling's solution. So sucrose cannot reduce Tollens reagent and Fehling's solution due to absence of free aldehyde group and ketone group. Hence, we can say that sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Very, very, very important one. Sucrose is a non-reducing disaccharide. And sucrose cannot undergo mutar rotation. Sucrose cannot undergo mutar rotation. Right. Whereas coming to remaining two disaccharides, maltose and lactose. Maltose is also another disaccharide. If you observe the structure of maltose is going to contain two simple monosaccharides. One is alpha D glucose. This is alpha D glucose. And this is alpha D glucose. C1 carbon of alpha D glucose is glycosidically linked with C4 carbon atom of alpha D glucose. Yes. Here at this C1 carbon, there is no free aldehyde group is present. But if you come to this C1 carbon, again, you will get it out. Sir, here also there is no free aldehyde group is present. But when this compound, maltose, is undergoing hydrolysis, this alpha D glucose unit at this C1 carbon atom, it can produce free aldehyde group. When the maltose is undergoing hydrolysis to produce two units of alpha D glucose units, the formed alpha D glucose units, they are going to have hemiacetal forms. They can reproduce the aldehyde group. Hence, that alpha D glucose units can reduce the Tollens reagent and Fehling's solution. So finally, we can say that maltose solution can reduce the Tollens reagent and Fehling's solution. So we can say that maltose is an example of reducing sugar, and maltose can show mutar rotation. Sucrose cannot show the mutar rotation. And maltose is an example of reducing sugar. Sucrose is an example of non-reducing sugar. Whereas coming to the next one, disaccharide, lactose. Let's see this one also. Lactose is known as a milk sugar because it is present in the milk. It is found in the milk. And lactose is composed of beta D galactose and beta D glucose. See these two structures, beta D galactose and beta D glucose. This is the C1 carbon atom. So C1 carbon atom is linked with C4 carbon atom of another beta D glucose with glycosidic linkage. Beta D galactose linked with beta D glucose through glycosidic linkage at C1 carbon atom of beta D galactose to C4 carbon atom of beta D glucose. When this is undergoing hydrolysis, yes, you can know what it is going to form. Beta D glucose unit is going to have hemiacetal form, it can rearrange itself to give a free aldehyde group. Hence, that form the free aldehyde group can reduce the toluene reagent and fill in the solution. So we can say that lactose solution can reduce the toluene reagent and fill in the solution. Then we can say that lactose, that is a disaccharide, that is an example of reducing sugar. So in the disaccharides, three disaccharides are given. One is the sucrose, second one is the maltose, third one is the lactose. Simply we can understand that sucrose is an example of non-reducing sugar, whereas maltose and lactose are the examples of reducing sugars. So once again, question number 24, volume 4, biomolecules chapter, page number 132, question number 24, which one of the following, which one given below is a non-reducing sugar? Sucrose is a non-reducing sugar. Yes, if you go for the remaining three options, what are the three options given there? First option given is sucrose. First option given is glucose. Third option given is maltose. Fourth option given is lactose. So now from these three options, option number one, option number three, option number four, we can understand that they are the examples of reducing sugars. So glucose, maltose, lactose are the examples of reducing sugars. Sucrose is an example of non-reducing sugar. So for the question number 24, option is 2. And coming to the 27th question, question number 27, the correct corresponding order of names of four aldoses with configuration given below. So here, four configurations of four compounds, four compounds configurations are given with respect to glyceraldehyde. The four compounds configurations are given with respect to glyceraldehyde. We have to give the configuration of four compounds with respect to glyceraldehyde. Yes, in the last 10 minutes back or 15 minutes back, I said about D plus glucose. Capital D hyphen plus glucose. Once again, I'm going to write the same. So before writing that one, I'm going to say about D plus glyceraldehyde. D plus glyceraldehyde. What is the structure of D plus glyceraldehyde? Just by taking a cross, at the top of the cross, aldehyde group is taken. At the bottom of the cross, CH2OH group is taken. At the right side of the cross, this is my right side. At the right side of the cross, OH group is taken. At the left side of the cross, hydrogen is taken. So if this configuration is observed, this is called as D configuration, capital D configuration. And this compound can rotate the plane polarized light in the clockwise direction. Of course, we can't say directly, it is experimental. The optical activity is experimental. So experimentally, it is known that this glucose is going to rotate the plane polarized light in the clockwise direction. Then we can say that it is a plus compound, that is dextro compound. And the name of the compound is glyceraldehyde. So this is the complete relative configuration of the compound D plus glyceraldehyde. So in the D plus glyceraldehyde, the OH group is present on the right side, hydrogen is present on the left side, CH2OH group. So in any of the carbohydrate, at the bottom of that structure of the carbohydrate, if we are going to have this type of configuration, then we have to say that is as D configuration, capital D, not small d. Small d stands for dextro. Here capital D stands for relative configuration of OH group and hydrogen with respect to CH-OH group, with respect to aldehyde group and CH2OH group. Now coming to the given four structures. Yes, here I'm going to write the first structure. CHO at the top, CH2OH at the bottom. Now, here it is OH and here it is H. Yes, irrespective of these groups, simply we can say that which configuration it is. Yes, it is a D configuration. And second compound. In the second compound, at the top, CHO is there. At the bottom, CH2OH is there. And here, OH is there, hydrogen is there. This is the second compound. No need of these groups. So again, it is having similarity with this configuration. Then we can say that this is a D configuration. Then the third compound given is at the top, CHO group, at the bottom, CH2OH, right? And at the left side here, hydrogen, here it is OH group. Whereas here, hydrogen is present on the left side, OH group is present on the right side, it is called as D. Whereas here, hydrogen is present on the right side, OH group is present on the left side, then it is called as capital L, capital L configuration. And the last compound, at the top, CHO group is taken, at the bottom, CH2OH group is taken, and here hydrogen is taken on the right side, OH group is taken on the left side. So which type of configuration it is? L configuration, L configuration, it is a D configuration, it is a D configuration. So for the question number 27, if you go for the option number 4, D erythrose, first compound is D erythrose. I am going to write all the groups. First compound is having OH and hydrogen. Second compound is having hydrogen and OH group. Third compound is having hydrogen and OH group. Fourth compound is having OH group and hydrogen. So all these compounds are known as carbohydrates. How can we say these are carbohydrates? What is the definition of carbohydrate? Optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. Once again, what are meant by carbohydrates? Optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones are called as carbohydrates. So here hydroxy group is there, here hydroxy group is there, and here aldehyde group is there, here different group is there. So this is an optically active compound having more number of hydroxy groups and having aldehyde group. So all these four compounds are the examples of carbohydrates. Once again, the definition of carbohydrate: optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones are called as carbohydrates, and all these are having the configurations D, D, L, L. If you go for the option number 4, question number 27, option number 4, D erythrose, this is the compound erythrose, D erythrose, D triose, L erythrose, and L triose. So trioses and erythroses are given. You have to remember the words trioses and erythroses. They are the carbohydrates. What is the definition of carbohydrate? Yes, tell me, what is the definition of carbohydrate? Yes, tell me once again. Otherwise, text me. Yes, what is the carbohydrate? Optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. They are called as carbohydrates. So this is all about the MCQs from the topic carbohydrates. So in the next video lecture, I'm going to teach you the MCQs regarding the topic proteins. But before going to know the proteins, we have to know about amino acids. Amino acids are classified again into two types: alpha amino acids and beta, essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. Of course, there is another classification of amino acids, that is alpha amino acids, beta amino acids, gamma amino acids, omega amino acids. So all these will be discussed in the next video lecture. The only thing we are requesting every day is you have to watch the every video till the end, because we don't know when the colleges are going to reopen, because still there is a pandemic happening throughout the world. So don't neglect the video lectures. Watch the video lectures till the end. Read the NCERT textbook, try to understand the concept, and then practice the MCQs. But before practicing the MCQs, once read the synopsis. And one more request: at the end of every chapter in the textbook, at the end of every chapter, some brief content is going to be given. That is total content about that chapter in a brief manner is going to be given. You have to read that one also. Then you can easily understand the concept, whatever given there. Then you can easily solve the MCQs. And one more thing, next February 23, that is in the year of 2021, February 23, the first JEE mains exam is going to be conducted by NTA. National Testing Academy is going to conduct the first JEE exam in the year of 2021. In the month of February, the date is 23rd. So please have some preparation for that examination. Of course, after February, March, April, May, again, there will be the examination for JEE. So I am requesting you all, please try to attend the first exam. Then you will have some idea about how to write the examination, how to face the examination. Right? Thank you, my dear students, for watching the video lectures. If you are having any doubt regarding any of the topic from my syllabus, you have to call me on my WhatsApp number 9490283667. Right? This is your chemistry lecture, Sir Naidu, signing off. Have a nice day.